my God. Just yesterday, I saw a video by Chris Boers, also known as the Irate Gamer, a trailer of his next review since coming back from his hiatus. He has a second review coming out. It's going to be Dick Tracy. And I know a lot of people are thinking, oh God, he's doing another review of a game that James Rolfe has already done. I'm like, so what? I've seen a lot of reviewers do the same subject that they're reviewing. It's not a big deal. But what I didn't expect from this trailer was something that I've been waiting for over 13 years. Ever since I knew who Irate Gaming was, and ever since I knew who James Wolfe was. We finally get to see a collaboration with these two. AVGN, the Angry Video Game Nerd, versus the Irate Gamer. My reaction when I saw that, I was screaming at the top of my lungs to the point that my wife and my son thought that something was wrong with me. That's how excited I was. I was like, no, I'm just excited for this. Now, of course, my son don't know much about these two, and he's not old enough to watch it, but my wife knows. And when I showed her the video, she understood because she knew the history between these two. On the fans themselves in this huge war with each other of saying that, oh, Chris Boers is a ripoff of AVGN and this and that. There was a huge fan war between that. And but there was not much of a war between the two parties. Because for one, they hardly mention each other. They hardly mention each other, you know what I mean? Like James didn't mention, even though when people ask about it, he chose not to talk about it. And with Chris Boers, you know, he did mention that, yeah, I did got some inspiration from James Rolfe, but at the end of the day, it was like there wasn't really much interaction between the two parties. And I've always wanted to see them work together or do some kind of collaboration. I mean, we've seen James Wolfe work with some of the best that the internet has to offer. One of them including the Nostalgia Critic. When people thought that Nostalgia Critic was ripping off James Wolfe, and then they actually got together and collab with each other, and it was gold. And I was thinking, like, let's see that with Irate Gamer, but I didn't think it was gonna happen. Until now, there were parts of me that felt like when James Rolfe made his first AVGN movie, I was thinking, will we see Chris Boers in it doing a cameo? Turns out we didn't. We didn't get to see that because, again, with the whole thing. But now, after over 13 years, we're finally gonna get this, and I cannot wait to see this. Again, for those of you who follow these two from the very beginning, from the genesis of YouTube, hearing people about their thoughts on Chris Boers ripping him off or, you know, doing the similar style, which I feel that, come on, like anyone, yeah, like James Wolfe didn't own that particular style of reviewing. You know what I mean? Like anyone's gonna pick it up and then make it their own, you know? And I felt that Chris Boers, so in some aspects, in most aspects, m made it his own. But of course, some people who see something that's doing good on the internet is gonna imitate it, and then eventually they're gonna make it into their own. And I feel he did that. So again, this really means a lot to me. And I know it means a lot to a lot of old fans like myself who've been following these two for years, or mostly following, you know, James Rolfe. But I'm really curious to see what other people like me think about it. I already talked to Saber King about it, and he's excited for this because he followed both of them. Even follow the news and the stories and the opinions of people who feel about, oh, Chris Boers rip him off. No, Chris Boers didn't rip him him off. It's just, you know, no one owns it, owns the that type of genre of reviewing, you know. So, yeah, I'm looking forward to this, guys. If you want to know what I'm talking about, there's a link down below to in the description of the video I'm talking about by the Irate Gamer. And I might do a review, a reaction to this. I might, because it's something that is near and dear to my heart, because I've always wanted to see these two collab, and we'll finally get to see it. I don't know what's going to happen. Sadly, there's not going to be much in the ways of, like, you know, one-on-one, you know, physical contact because of the situation we're in. You know, that would have been good. You know, I think it would have been great if they did had a chance to meet face-to-face and they did something kind of like with the nostalgia critic Doug Walker and James Wolfe did for so many years. But we get what we get. The fact of hearing James Wolfe actually mention the Irate Gamer's name is just enough to know that this is going to be epic. 13 years, over 13 years in the making. And I can't wait, guys. I'd like to know what your guys' thoughts on this. And what are your current thoughts of Chris Boers? Do you still think he's a ripoff? Or is this something that we should, like, put the past to the past? Although not really putting the past to the past, because right now this collaboration is bringing back the past. So I'd like to know your guys' thoughts. Comment down below. Give me your thoughts and opinions. And we got to discuss in a bit about it. And if you're new to my channel, please subscribe to my channel. Also follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. And please go to Cinemassacre's YouTube channel. Please subscribe. Go to Chris Neo or Chris Boers, the Irate Gamer's channel. Please subscribe and check out all of his most of his content. And also check out my show, Battle Mode. So, this is Dude Dreamer. Always dream big. And let's get ready for a huge, huge ride. Take care.